Hello everyone, we have with us Mr. Manish Mundra. We are happy that Manish is here with us, and he will be sharing his poetry with us today. The discussion will primarily focus on poetry. Manish has published his first debut collection of poems, Mosaic. This is the book. We welcome you, Manish, for being a part of the Bangalore Literature Festival.
Thank you very much. Thank you for staying back. It's been an honor and a pleasure to be here to read some of the poems of my book and hope it will touch your heart, because it's all written by heart and it's straight from my soul down. And I'm not a literature student. But of course, we all study literature as we grow up, and we all experience our own process through which we live life, and that makes us to write. It has also helped me to pen down some of my thoughts. Of course, I generally write in Hindi, but then there are some things which you express well also in English, and they look good and heard well when you write in English. So I'll start with one poem, and then you can take your questions from there. Okay, I'll read this, the poem which is the centerpiece, which is the name, the same, Mosaic. It can be you, it can be him, it can be she, it can be them. Everyone here has been through pain. Everyone here will be rendered broken by disdain. You are not alone, neither will you be the only one. So what if you are fragmented? So what if you are fragmented? So what if you hold cracks tormented? We all carry the patchwork, making up this beautiful mosaic world. That's the poem. Thank you.
Thank you for sharing your poem. My first question to you is about how the book came along. In the introduction itself, Pritish Nandi has written that any artist at some point in their life, they write poetry. And you are like the artist of the greatest degree we can imagine. You do photography, you're a well-known filmmaker, you are also an entrepreneur, not to discount the paintings that you have done in the book. So how does poetry fit into this, your own mosaic of artistic pursuits?
Thank you. First of all, these sketches are not done by me. These sketches are done by a very talented lady. Her name is Mayuri Shahane. She has done it brilliantly, and it actually resonates with the poems which we have written, and it has been edited by Ishmit. She is here, and thank you very much, Ishmit, for whatever good they see in this poem. Coming back to the question, I, of course, as a human being, as I said earlier in one of the sessions, that I'm living through a journey. We all pass through the journey. The fun is passing through that journey. Us safar ka ek anand lete hain hum. और सफर को जब हम तय करते हैं तो कई चीजें हमारे सामने से गुजरती हैं, या तो हम उसको जी लेते हैं और भूल जाते हैं, या जी लेते हैं और लिख लेते हैं। तो ये विचार जो है पूरे दिल से हैं, जो भी हमने देखा सुना गुजरा उसको लिखा है, और बहुत दिल से लिखा हुआ है, स्ट्रक्चर्ड ऑफकोर्स थैंकफुली बाई इश्मित, बट दिल से जो आया वो लिख दिया, एंड दैट्स हाउ आई केम टू आई गॉट द कॉन्फिडेंस टू कंपाइल इट इनटू अ बुक एंड गेट इट in form of mosaic. And Pritish Nandi ji was kind enough to read through it and write the introduction, and Dr. Ranganathan wrote the foreword, and I was thrilled to read what they wrote about this, and I felt it was a good job done. But I'd like to read the introduction which I wrote for the book, the very purpose of the book, which answers your question, and I don't know if I would be able to do justice by reading it, but you can feel the emotions into it. So this book was dedicated to life, for empowering me to take the paths I was destined to walk through, knowingly or unknowingly, for ensuring that I experienced the amazing trajectory of love, pain, success, failures, rejections, and unaccountable acceptances. I dedicate this book to amazing souls that held me, believed in me, supported me, completed me, to the few who completely understood me, and the souls who are going to touch my life in future, making it as eventful as it was till now. That's what I wrote as a reason why I wrote this book.
Dedicated to life. Your own life has been a roller coaster. I mean, I was reading about you. You started in Devghar, and you were at one point in life as a child, you were selling cola on the streets. And then you ensured that you get education. And by the time you were in your early 30s, you were already CEO of a company working in Africa, and then setting up Drishyam Films in Bollywood, in Bombay. So this has, I mean, I'm sure you are working on hundreds of projects, like, you know, it keeps you busy. So where does poetry fit in? Were you writing poems as a child? Were you writing poems when you were in college as a young corporate guy, or is poetry a newfound pursuit? How has poetry fit into this life that you talk about?
Scribbling was always part of life. You know, whenever we were kids, we would scribble, we'll write, we'll do notes. But yes, the structure, what we are looking today, jo aaj hum dekhte hain, hamare saamne hai, wo last 10-15 years is what we have been writing in a very structural form. Jo bhi vichar aate hain, jo bhi thoughts aate hain, jo unko ek structure form mein likhna, and with the advent of phone in our hands, it became more easier that whatever thoughts would come anywhere in around, if you're traveling, if you're flying, mostly when you're flying, thoughts would come in. You just type down in the notes and then mail yourself and compile it. That became more important as a tool, the phone, that you started structuring. So last 15-20 years is what I've been writing more diligently and more sensibly, as you can say, in a more structured form.
Why don't you share something else, another poem or maybe a couple?
So this poem, since I am a filmmaker too, I produce films, and also recently I directed my first film. I wrote and directed one first feature film, which soon will be out. Maybe in March we'll release the film. Some of my films, if you are not aware, I started with Aankho Dekhi, then made Newton, Masaan, Waiting, Dhanak, Ram Prasad Ki Terwi, Kamyab. So got 5 national awards, and as a producer. And filmmaking is just a passion, that we should make good cinema in this country. So I wrote this poem as a filmmaker. When I go through the rushes of my life, and when I see through the flashbacks, when I rewind my reels, I realize in my life's screenplay why I met you, so that you could find me, hold me, guide me. So what if in the climax, the end result was not as what we desired, we still completed the story. As the end credits roll with the background score, I now reason why God scripted the scenes, the effects so divine. I realize in my mind, in the film of my life, why I met you. You completed me. You helped me explore my story, my film, my life. Okay, this is obdurate. It's for all young ones here and those who come from very humble background, from small town villages, want to dream big and become big. This is for you all. And this was my heart, which I wrote about myself, and I thought one day I'll tell to the world. It goes by the title Obdurate. From the very beginning of our life, we are attuned to surrender, to give up, to obey orders, to give away to the ringleaders, to follow what is told, to leave the space for someone more beautiful, someone more powerful, someone more privileged, someone more leveraged. Now, no more. No more surrender, no more compromise, no more being pushed aside. You are beautiful, you are talented, You have worked hard. You are worthy. You can't let it go. You can't give up your space anymore. Be obdurate. Sink your teeth and dig your feet in. Hold it. What is yours, never let it go.
Thank you for those poems, Manish. Filmmaking is probably the most expensive form of art. If you are an artist and if you want to express your art in some form, filmmaking is probably the, and poetry is the most inexpensive. Like all you need is a pen and paper. Kabir didn't even need that. Like many poets can just recite poems. They don't even need a pen and paper. So how do the two marry in your life? Like how do you, is there an event when a film has inspired you to write a poem? Or has there been an incident when you thought about a poem and you thought, oh, this idea is beautiful, I can expand it into a film? Do such exchanges happen within your different art forms?
Yeah, it does. And of course, even though we can call it as one of the simplest and one of the poorest form of art, poetry, but it's one of the most impactful. With few lines, you can impact, you can create, you can communicate what you want to communicate. Dil se dil ki baat hoti hai, wali baat hai. So it's nevertheless very important that you write. And every big dream has humble beginnings. If cinema is, of course, a costly affair, which I don't believe anymore now that it's a costly affair. But poems do help you to flourish and nourish your creative side. It helps you to write your thoughts, structure it properly, and communicate in the smallest possible way. And that's what exactly filmmaking is, that we have a story, but then we need to create scenarios, create scenes and create plates that can communicate and convey the message to the audience very well. So both are form of art and both are valuable, invaluable forms. And of course, there have been various places, at least a couple of times in my films which I produced, I used my poetry which were converted into lyrics. And then the recent one which I actually directed, I have a poem in the trailer itself, where I myself have recited the poetry while I cut the trailer of 2 to 2.5 minutes. It talks about the journey of a woman. So of course they both complement each other. If you write well, I'm sure you can visualize well. And if you visualize well, I'm sure you can make films well and understand films well. So they both are important part of you from the artistic point of view.
Thank you, Manish. आपने कहा दिल की बात होती है. आपने हिंदी की भी कविताएं लिखी हैं. आप ज्यादातर हिंदी में कविताएं लिखते हैं और आपकी हिंदी की कविताओं की किताब छपी भी है, आप बता रहे थे. तो क्यों ना आप हिंदी की अपनी कुछ कविताएं साझा करें विद द ऑडियंस हियर.
कोई याद नहीं रहता, मैं ढूंढता हूँ फोन में,
जरूर
अगर मिल जाती है तो. बहुत अच्छी अच्छी कविताएं उसमें, अभी तो फोन पे पता नहीं वो मिलेंगी कि नहीं मिलेंगी, बट मैंने अभी कल लिखी एक, वो मैं पढ़ देता हूँ.
जरूर
सामने, एक्चुअली हम पढ़ रहे थे. उन नजरों से बाहर की ओर देखो जिनसे तुम खुद के अंदर झांकते हो. उन नजरों से बाहर की ओर देखो जिनसे तुम खुद के अंदर झांकते हो. सब कुछ गहरा दिखेगा, विस्मृत होता छलावा, सच्ची होती छाया. आंखें बंद करके भी सब कुछ साफ दिखेगा, बिना असमंजस की पीली परतों के. उन नजरों से बाहर की ओर देखो जिनसे तुम खुद के अंदर झांकते हो.
और भी कुछ पढ़िए ना हिंदी का, अगर आपके पास है तो.
ढूंढता हूँ
जी.
This is another poem which is named as Man Enough. I am a man. I have been conditioned. Men don't cry. But what if pain becomes unbearable? Emotions can't hold anymore. Soul is ripped and tormented. I do cry. Am I still a man enough? I need to cry. It makes me real to breathe and feel the ease. I need to cry to be human and express what I feel. It's good to feel the pain time and again. Am I still a man enough?
Manish, a lot of your poems are about love. They're about being vulnerable.
Yeah.
They're about hope. How do you relate to these emotions in the times we are living in? We are not living in the most hopeful of times, honestly. Given the way the economy, the society, the state of politics, also the pandemic to top it all. So how do you place your poems in the times we are living in, and how do you think they affect the reader, or how they have affected you as a writer?
Of course, we are living through very turbulent times, very emotional times, difficult times, mostly because of pandemic. We all have gone through tough times. One way or other, one of our relatives or near ones, dear ones have been affected, impacted. And it has mentally touched us, of course, physically and emotionally too. These are tough times, but then one thing which drives me is the hope. Hope that things would be better, hope that things would be wonderful from here. Things would be normal again, and that probably we will be making more out of our life what we were not doing earlier and when we took life for granted. So one thing which always comes in my mind every day when I wake up is that there's a new day to live and a new hope to work upon. That drives me to do more and more. I don't know. I'm more than 48 now, and earlier pre-pandemic, I was not so much concerned about life. We always thought that it is endless, but post these couple of years, suddenly you feel that it is going to end, and that you should make most of it. Try and fulfill all your dreams and not wait for the right time. So what I think and what I feel in nowadays is that let's take life head on. Let's enjoy the journey and do the best what we could do. Living through this journey happily and eventfully, because it's not necessary that we'll be happy always. We have our dull moments. We have our tough times. But then ensure that it is eventful. We are doing one other thing one day or other. So we are totally engrossed, living the life full and dreaming big and continuously dreaming. Don't stop dreaming. Be hopeful, work hard, and give back to the society. That's how I look at it nowadays.
Giving back to the society, speaking of which, you have made news not just as a filmmaker and a businessman, but also as a philanthropist, especially during the COVID pandemic, during the lockdowns. You did a lot of work. And all of it was done through Twitter and mostly through social media. Do you want to share a little bit about that experience? And the second part of my question is, has that experience nudged you in a way to create art? Are you planning to make a film or write poetry or any other form of art that has been taken inspiration from the experiences you have had during the past 2 years?
Of course, we all went through, if we remember, two waves till now. First wave, where we were not aware of what was happening, the fear of unknown. We didn't know. What we knew was our frontline warriors, that's the nurses, the doctors, and the hospital staff needs to be protected. And the first thing we were struggling was of PPE kit. I think when we started, India was not prepared in terms of manufacturing PPE kits. And since I was traveling outside, I'd stay outside. And it had started already in Europe and Americas. The one important thing where everybody was talking there was also PPE kit. And so I thought it's time that we should look in India also to start working on how to get PPE kit and distribute it as much as possible. The first thing what we did in the first wave was to distribute PPE kit to the hospitals across India. And I think if I remember correctly, we did more than 60,000 PPE kits across more than 35 cities across India. And that in the first phase and we imported a lot of PPE kit, and then slowly and steadily India started manufacturing. So the first phase was more related to PPE kits and supply of foodstuffs, because everything was locked down and people were left out without any plant. So distribution of the food and the kit, that was important. That we did through social media, because everybody was inside and everybody was connected in the cities through social media, and we could move around whatever we could through various volunteers across the country. So that was the first phase. And second phase, when it came again, then the oxygen concentrator became one of the important aspects, because we were very very well with in terms of PPE kit, but then we were not very prepared from the point of view of oxygen concentrators and oxygen supply, and a lot of people lost their life because of that. So then again, we gathered and we worked together to import a lot of oxygen concentrators from China, unfortunately from China and Russia and everywhere. And we could distribute it to the various cities across India. We imported almost 6,000 oxygen concentrators, and the whole of the distribution was through social media network, especially through Twitter. We could do it. And I thank people all across India, volunteers all across India, and the social media, which became one important tool to reach out to the people, and we could save a lot of life. Coming to the second question, yes, of course, it has impacted when you... Then the part of the second wave was also getting beds in the hospital. That was one of the difficult phase where people died in queue. And that impacted us a lot mentally to me, emotionally to me. I could feel that I was getting into that mode, that their pain became my pain. And I had to cut off actually to help myself. But those marks, those scars remain with you forever. And I have already penned down a story. We don't know when we'll convert into film, but of course, I'm very sure that a lot of people will have those experiences, which should be noted, which should be booked and written in form of books, poems, or films. And people, the coming generation should read about it, understand how we fought through this and survived together. And also we should also not forget what we went through.
So since we're at the end of the session, why don't you share a couple of more poems with us?
This is a small poem which is very close to me, and it's my reality. It is titled Life and Time. I don't fear death, I'm sure. But when death does come to me, I wish to have enough time to recollect all the good that was bestowed upon me. I need that time before I breathe my last, some time for recollection and reflection. Those moments of grace to me would be worth a lifetime in itself. Last one I would read is called Stampede. We were killed in stampede. Too much emotions, too much attachments, too much love. Panicked rush and then the fall, toppled by the fear of losing it all. I know I'm always speeding in a crowd, vulnerable and exposed, but that's me. Either I want to do it all or I just don't want it at all. Thank you. Thank you for being here.
Thank you, Manish. Thank you, Bangalore Literature Festival, for hosting.